On Bishop Barra's YouTube channel, you will find exclusive content to uplift your faith. The Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo. Live meetings from Bishop Barra Fonseca. Testimonies, thoughtful advice, prayers, and much more. Do you like it? Then subscribe today and share the videos on your social network. You are listening now to A Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo.
Hello, my dear listeners. May God bless all of you, you who believe, those of you who believe in Jesus' name. And I would like for you to pay close attention to the scripture in which we chose for you to understand, so that you may have an understanding of God's greatness and the glory of the Holy Spirit within us. Let us read 1 Corinthians 2:16. The Apostle Paul, guided by the Holy Spirit, he brings this affirmation, this confirmation. For who has known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him? Who has known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him? And then he adds, but we have the mind of Christ. We have the mind of Christ. Now the question is, and it's going to answer all those people that have been writing to us and asking, Bishop, how do I know that I have the Holy Spirit? What is the reason I can say I have indeed the Holy Spirit? Well, my dear listener, this certainty and conviction the Holy Spirit gives to us. Because if we are certain of what it is written and what is promised, and God's greatness has been manifesting in us through the person of the Holy Spirit, then there is no reason to doubt or to even question. It is obvious that Satan will use people's faith in order to convince them that they have the Holy Spirit. And many are those that say they have the Holy Spirit, but therefore they don't really have because of the fruits in their life. So you truly want to know if you have the Holy Spirit or not. So look at the fruits of your life. Take a look at the fruits of your life. Bring about the fruits of the flesh in one side and the fruits of the Spirit on another side. The fruits of the flesh is lies, betrayal, deceit, promiscuity, people that keep cursing, using foul language, people that keep seeking the things of the internet, people that are feeding themselves with the internet, especially of the things that are so filthy and dirty. These are the people that do not have the Holy Spirit, because those who have the mind of Christ only does what is good. Whoever has the mind of Christ, which is through the Holy Spirit, only seeks to do good for others. So if a person has the Holy Spirit, They don't walk with bad feelings of vengeance, of revenge. They forgive. They are that kind of person that has peace. When you talk to someone that has the Holy Spirit, they transmit peace. They transmit peace to those who don't have. More than peace, joy as well. It's good to be around them. And when a person has or says they have love, we can also be confused. God's love with the love of this world. Because the world's love is that feeling of interest, personal interest. There is an interest after that. A person who says, for example, I want to be happy and I want to get married. Well, when a person has the Holy Spirit, they are already happy because they have the mind of Christ within them. But when they do not have the Holy Spirit, they say, I need to get married so I can be happy. When a person has the Holy Spirit, they say, I want to make someone happy. Because I'm happy, I want to bring happiness to someone else's life. And that's completely different, right? A person who has the Holy Spirit, they want to bless and bring joy to someone else's life. In the beginning of the marriage, they want to make someone happy. And that's a big difference between those who have and those who don't. So you can verify, my dear listener, that when a person has God's Spirit, they have God's vision. For instance, Jesus, he was baptized in waters, and immediately he received the Holy Spirit. From that moment, the Holy Spirit took him to the desert to be tempted, to be tested. So what Jesus did, immediately he also started a fast of 40 days and 40 nights. He stayed in fasting. He ate absolutely nothing. And why? Because he knew that he was going to face hell. He was going to face Satan face to face. So then, what takes place? He refused. He sacrificed his body so that he could have this conviction of faith so that he could be prepared to face Satan. But then a question is, but Bishop, I received the Holy Spirit, but I was not taken to the desert. Well, Jesus said that you will receive the Holy Spirit, you will receive power of the Holy Spirit, and you will also receive fire, because right after the baptism of the Holy Spirit comes the test of fire, the desert. And when a person goes through the desert and they do not survive, they do not make it, it's because they don't have the Holy Spirit. So from the moment that they receive the Holy Spirit, they have strength. They have God's Spirit. They have the mind of God. So much so that Jesus, he began a fast. When a person has the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit guides, give them a tip so that the person can do and put it to action, and then they are able to resist the problem, the tribulations that soon come. So, for example, when a person goes through the desert, if they have the Holy Spirit, they are going to overcome. But if they go to the desert alone, without the Holy Spirit, they will not survive. They will not make it. That's why so many people that are out there, they are ex-former assistants, former pastor's wife, former bishops that are no longer bishops. So all these former people that had a title that was once used by God, they are proving to those who have the Holy Spirit that they don't have the Holy Spirit, and that's why they fell. And now they have been embraced by the desert, consumed. And some fall even to the world. Others try to do the work of God, but they can't make it. And sooner or later they are going to give up. But what I want you to know is that when a person receives the Holy Spirit, they receive happiness. Do you want some? Can someone else make you happy? Only those who have the Holy Spirit can make someone happy, because the Holy Spirit makes us happy, regardless of the problems, regardless of the tribulation, regardless of the problems you face at home. You may be even persecuted by your own family members, for instance. How can you resist that? You can resist that with the Holy Spirit. They persecute you because they think that you are fanatic. They think that you are better than them. They think that you are going crazy or being brainwashed. But when you have the Holy Spirit, you have peace. Although they say those things, although they are against you, you even love them back, because the Holy Spirit is inside of you. And this is the reason. This is what you can see through the testimonies. And when a person has the Holy Spirit, they want to pass to others what they have received. They do not become secluded in their own world. No, they want to share. They want to spread. They go after those who are in suffering, like they were, to make them, to bring them happiness with the Holy Spirit. So when Paul says here that we have the mind of Christ, he is referring to the Christians in the church in the Corinth. He's not talking to the unbelievers. This letter here, for instance, was written to all those that have been converted there in Corinth. So then, they were truly of the faith. They were truly born of God, and they received the Holy Spirit.
I'm caught up in your presence. I just want to sit here at your feet. I'm caught up in this holy moment. I never want to leave. Oh, I'm not here for blessings. Jesus, you don't owe me anything. More than anything that you can do, I just want you. I'm sorry when I've just gone through the motions. I'm sorry when I just sang another song. Take me back to where we started. I open up my heart to you. I'm sorry when I've come with my agenda. I'm sorry when I forgot that you're enough. Take me back to where we started. I open up my heart to you. I'm caught up in your presence. Nothing else. else will do. I just want you and nothing else, and nothing else, nothing else will do. More